Welcome to JSA TV, the newsroom for tech and telecom professionals. I'm Jamie Scott-Okataya. Here in beautiful Honolulu, take a look at this drone footage care of X-Site Modula. Unbelievable PTC'19. Joining me here today, my good friend, Mr. Vincent English, of course, the CEO of Megaport. Vincent, welcome to JSA TV again.
Great, thanks very much for having me. Voice is going a little bit here now, but I'll be okay.
Yeah, we'll get you right through this. But it's a pleasure to have you back again. Since the last time, it's every time I check into Megaport, there's growth. It's a growth story. So tell us, how many customers are now using Megaport's global software-defined network?
Well, we've over 1,200. I think it's about 1,277 customers today on our network at the end of December. Continuing to grow. It's about 10% a quarter. We're growing customers, which is great. I think it just proves out the investment in not only in the technology in our platform, but also the reach of our network. So it's allowing more and more customers to connect to us. We had some great magic milestones that happened pretty much during our quarter, half year ending in December. Monthly recurring revenue in our U.S. market, where we've invested quite a lot, hit the $1 million mark at the end of December. So that was a huge testament to all the work and hard commitment we've put into this market. So we're delighted with that. It's work in progress, but it's going in the right way. So it's great.
It's amazing. So what do you see as driving all this growth? Like, what are the customers' benefits that keep them coming back for more?
I think it's probably threefold. There's a couple of different things that are really important to the market. I think the first one is, I think the cloud providers themselves today have done a really excellent job on not only educating the market about the cloud services and the applications that they're using, but also there's been a comfort or a credibility with people accepting those services are now part of business as usual in any kind of IT or business transformation. I suppose the second thing that's really important on the flip side of that is that enterprises, our customers today, are also accepting the fact that, you know, cloud is here today and it's going to stay, and it's part of the IT infrastructure, as part of what they're to run their business. And you need to leverage some of your own infrastructure, private infrastructure, plus using the public cloud. And so the combination of both of those two means that there's a demand both from the customers and it's a demand within from the cloud providers to provide the services. And the third component is where Megaport fits in, is the connectivity. And this is what's really important. To allow for speed and the adoption of cloud, it needs to happen fast. And the cloud connectivity fast is where Megaport comes in, giving the customer ease of access, ease of use, and the speed to connect so that they can get to the cloud now and quickly.
So talking cloud, you had some great logos on your website, I noticed. Can you tell our viewers who are some of those top cloud service providers that your customers can connect to? And tell us a little bit about the value of this multi-cloud environment.
Sure, yeah. We've fully integrated the top seven cloud providers today that account for, I think, over three quarters of the cloud market in terms of the market share. AWS and Microsoft Azure, Google, we've got IBM, Oracle, Salesforce, and then Alibaba at the moment.
All the big ones.
They're top seven. We're still working on it. We've got a few more in the pipeline that we're working on the software side and on our integration side. But I think on top of that, not just on the cloud side of things, we've got over 300 service providers today that are not cloud providers, but other service providers that are using our network to connect to services. So it's actually a multi-use platform from a connectivity point of view.
So important.
That's a secret to our success, the fact that we're able to use our software, which is within the software-defined network, to actually connect to the cloud providers. And we've got a very good relationship with them. And we had some great meetings with the providers today here at PTC and yesterday. So still a full day ahead tomorrow. But they're an integral part of our business and how they help transform users using their IT platforms and their applications, so it's very important for us.
And I will say that Megaport has been teaching us over the years how to really redefine connectivity. You really keep turning it on its edge and keep teaching us further and further. So now that I have the thought leader himself here, 2019, 2020 is around the corner, a whole new decade. What's the future of connectivity?
Look, I think software is going to be the key word there in software-defined networks. I mean, software is an enabler. It removes manual processes and inefficiencies in terms of how it takes time to actually do things and connect things and provision services. I think the ability for customers who don't have necessarily all the core skill sets or the tools to actually get their head around networking don't necessarily need it to. So we've actually used software to make the customer journey and the user experience to connect to services very simple and kind of a step by step, 1, 2, 3, kind of connect to services. Ultimately, businesses today are looking to the end service or the application that they want to use and not necessarily the process of how to get there. And I think it's that instant gratification that we all use as consumers today, whether we're downloading music or TV or whatever. The same thing happens in the IT world. That needs to transform in the point where actually it can actually happen real time. And that's what we're enabling. I see that as a kind of a key, a future for technology in general, but also just for connectivity, whether it's with the telco environment or with fiber infrastructure or data centers or within the cloud. Megaport is sort of in that space. That's the unique position that we have in the market where we enable all that. We're going to continue to invest in that and that whole journey and how the customer gets there. But I think software is a key component of it. And I think lastly, you know, in terms of not just the trends for, say, Megaport or for our business or in general, I think data is a key component. Data has been growing at an exponential rate for the last couple of years, and it's not slowing down. It's going to continue. And data needs to move, and it needs to connect between applications or places or locations for it to happen, whether you're talking with artificial intelligence, machine learning, autonomous vehicles, all of those things, data has to move. And so connectivity is a key component in making that happen, and we're glad to be in the space. That's what we love doing and getting part of being connectivity. So that's it.
Smart answers. SDN, AI, machine learning. This is what's happening, and you're certainly helping us enable this. So we look forward to learning more and watching you guys grow. Where can our viewers go if they want to learn more?
Megaport.com. Pretty much that's where you can catch us. It's all there, all the knowledge, the tools, how the portal, how to access, get your download, your demo, go through, you get your portal on, check out all the services and how you can connect. Got a lot of exciting things coming up in 2019, more locations, more markets being turned up, and looking forward to seeing you again at the next event.
Absolutely. Vincent, thank you so much for joining us. Again, guys, megaport.com. It's a growth story, one to watch. Thank you for tuning in to JSA TV. Happy networking.